Yes, hello, my name is Christopher. Tuesday's top story, computer users stand today accused of ripping and burning the music industry to fiery shreds.
We've got 15 awards that are going to be handed out today to Claw. Rather familiar.
Oh, God.
You can't keep up the
what
show.
What a surprise.
You need to do that again, yeah?
Definitely. Stories now. The Italian ice cream salesman Luciano Pavarotti has appeared in an Italian court to face tax. The former Weight Watcher of the Year has pleaded not guilty to filing in false tax returns from 1989 to 1995. Lucky Luciano says he shouldn't pay because he sweats most of the time in Monte Carlo, not in Italy. If convicted, he faces up to 3 years in a specially reinforced pasta cell made of deep frozen whole wheat spaghetti. Facts from BBC News.
It's making me laugh, this show. I should watch it.
Yeah. Sparrow Eliza Doolittle's in the money. That's just 18 weeks after she started going down a treat up west, which is something I've done. The stage... Oh, stop it. You're pandering, eh? Cheap.
It's a real shock. He was an excellent broadcaster. I mean, a lot of people said he had great potential, but, you know, he was a brilliant broadcaster as he was. Very funny, very cutting, very professional, and he'll be sadly missed.
Christopher made me better at my job because he was a tough person to work with. He'd give you some hardball questions that you weren't expecting when you were in a live situation from Sunset Boulevard or somewhere bizarre like that. And he really just was such a perfectionist to a certain extent that it made you a perfectionist and it made you work that bit harder because you were always trying to keep up with him.
At the moment, I'm just in shock like everybody else. It just seems such a tragedy. This was a man who undoubtedly had a great future in front of him. There's no doubt about that. He would have gone on, I think, to have been one of the foremost broadcasters of his age.
He was just adorable. I mean, big teddy bear, great fun, easy to work with. I mean, Liquid News was just one of those dream jobs that you just... The phone goes, they say, oh, come and do Liquid News. You go, yeah, great.
It's quite rare when you meet someone who's on television every day and yet doesn't seem to be obsessed with their own persona or fame. And you know, like I said, it's not particularly frequent in television, so it's refreshing.
But I just thought he was a natural broadcaster. And I don't know anyone who spent any time in his company who didn't come away thinking he was terrific.
Even with very hard news, he was always looking for the lighter touch, he was always looking for a bit of humour, and he had plenty of that. He was quite cutting and he could be quite sarcastic, and I loved the style.
I think the main thing about Christopher is he was just never anything but himself. He was incredibly original, and he's just a delight.
I'll describe Christopher as a big ball of loveliness and cuddles and fun and laughter.
He was my best friend, and all of the things that a best friend brings to any kind of relationship he had. He was reliable, he was funny, he was always there to pick me up when I was going through rough times. I hope a lot of the time I was there for him.
My name is Christopher Price. I've been expecting you.
Well, let's cross live to Park City. And our very own ski bunny, Mr. Tom Brook. Hi, how you doing? Why am I sensing there's a kind of air of a porn set going on there? I don't know why I'm saying that, but I do sense that, Tom.
You've got a very fertile imagination, that's all I'll say.
You're displaying your legs, Tom, for goodness sake. Bless you. But anyway,
I've got to cross my legs now.
That just looks really camp, Tom. Thousands of gay men assembled in a park, and for once it was daylight. Europe's largest gay and lesbian fandango was held in London's Finsbury Park under the banner of Mardi Gras. Midriffs were naked, whistles were blown, whoever that is, and the cream of Britain's sing-along of Pop-Tarts were on stage. Just saying no to poppers for Liquid News, Alex Stanger.
I remember one show, it was just full of innuendo. I hadn't giggled like a schoolboy every time he said like a pun on a rude word, and he, of course, denied it and looked at me. And it was that sense of fun that was, you know, so engaging.
Hello.
Hello.
You brought me some gifts, haven't you?
It's a little bit of Vaseline. I was watching you before.
Bit chat.
Bit. May I?
You can. How are you, by the way? This is
very well. Very sorry about that, guy. Give us...
I don't pout very well.
Well, you should. How are you? Check this out. doesn't he look fabulous?
We spent Boxing Day together, Christopher and I, and he came over to the house. He was not actually feeling very well, and I was doing a bit of ladies relaxing cross stitch, and I really don't think he actually ever quite got over it.
He managed to make sort of acerbic and bitchy, incisive, cutting comments without ever really being nasty and without being offensive.
He sailed so close to the wind. I mean, there was a lot of sexual innuendo, which just makes me laugh, really does. So all that kind of, the smut. You know, there was some good smut on Liquid News, and he knew it, and he knew he was getting away with it. And he just seemed to be revelling.
Sorry, I can't come out with anything that's that usual kind of anodyne, sentimental thing, but it just doesn't feel appropriate with Christopher, because he wasn't like that.
Someone today was asking me to sum up the best moment of Liquid News, of Christopher on Liquid News, or Zero 30 or Radio 5 Live, and I said to them that really his best moments were off screen, not on the radio. He was just a fantastic friend.
Those were the main entertainment news stories of the last 7 days. But before we go, we here at Liquid News said goodbye this week to our friend and colleague Christopher Price. Christopher died 2 weeks ago. He was only 34. Last Wednesday, his funeral was held in London.
Remember, we simply choose to